I want to get your thought on the sentiment too. I feel like this year, this is the year that Aaron Nola wins a Cy Young, and that's just my thoughts.
Really?
Yeah,
Okay.
I feel like, and this is my thing too. This just came to my head. I don't know what it is. I think really Nola, I mean, maybe in any other year in 2018, he could have won a Cy Young. It was just Jacob deGrom and Max Scherzer exist. So, he didn't win that year. I think he came in third in 2018. Nola, I feel like if he can just get it going from the start to the finish, like he did in 2018, he can win a Cy Young. And this is the year he's going to do it. I'm telling you. And he's going to get all these Phillies haters out of here that say that he's not the ace, which is for whatever stupid reason. He has like a bad month and it's like, oh, this guy sucks. He's not the pitcher we thought he was. Like, relax. I think he's going to win the Cy Young this year. That's my prediction. But
All right, so Francis, I'm going to play devil's advocate a little bit. I haven't dropped this tweet yet, but I was
okay.
planning to just to stir up Phillies Twitter a little bit.
Of course.
I love Aaron Nola. He's the best pitcher on the staff. Absolutely incredible. I'm so happy he's on the team, paying whatever the heck he wants when his contract is expired. Like, I'm all in on Aaron Nola. I don't think he's an ace. And the only reason I say this is I think the word ace is wildly overused in baseball today. I think there's only a handful in the MLB. Like, do you really view him in the same light as a Jacob deGrom or a Gerrit Cole or, a healthy Justin Verlander?
Well, I mean, the names you're naming though are legends already,
Well,
except
that's who I
for
would view as aces.
yeah, but that's dude, that's legends. That's what that's you could have an ace and it not be a legend. I mean, I'm trying to think. Cole
So
Hamels
do
was an
you,
ace, but he all right, he's a Phillies legend, but
wow,
he's
you're a
not a
World Series MVP.
but he's not an but is Cole Hamels a Major League Baseball legend? No, he's a Phillies legend and he was an ace.
Okay.
Stop that.
So
Let
do you view ace as just the best pitcher on your staff, or do they have to be a
yeah.
certain level of good? Okay, then.
Hold up though. I mean, you can have a really bad staff and I mean, let's look at 2011 Phillies. I mean, there were four aces on the staff, right? So
Oh,
it's
those were four proper aces. I agree with that.
yeah, it depends on the team, I guess. I'd say most teams, like you look at the White Sox, I mean, Lance Lynn and Giolito could probably be one and two. You could say whoever's the ace over there. I mean, like I said, the names you named, like DeGrom is generational pitcher. DeGrom is disgusting. Gerrit Cole's generational pitcher probably. And I forget who the other guy you named was, but
I said like a healthy
yeah,
Verlander.
I mean Verlander is a Hall of Famer. Like these
Yeah,
are, you know what I
absolutely. I'm
mean?
not disagreeing with that.
Yeah,
No,
I mean,
this
look,
is
if
gonna
Aaron
make me look
Nola's
like
not
a
a Hall of
Nola
Famer,
A.
but he gives me a Cy Young, I'm cool with that. But that's just my
If
thoughts.
Nola wins a Cy Young, so now if Nola wins a Cy Young, they're gonna make the playoffs. Like, do you agree with that?
No, because I mean he did that in 2018. He should have, just like Carson
Yeah.
Wentz really won the MVP in 2017, but
Yeah.
political crap. Yeah, it doesn't matter.
Well, 2018, Phillies didn't have Bryce Harper. That's a
They didn't.
pretty big addition.
It is, but that's my whole thing. I want to talk about that real quick. I want to get your thoughts on this. My whole thing is that like people love to say that we can't waste the talent or the peak of Real Muto, Harper, Nola, even want to throw in Zach Wheeler there. What I mean, but like to me, like I wrote about this a couple weeks ago. To me, this isn't the NBA though. Like this isn't like you can have three or four good players on a team and you can suck, honestly, in baseball. You gotta have a good bullpen, you gotta have a good starting rotation, you have to have good offense and sprinkled in with a little good defense too. Like you gotta have everything. And to me, it's like people are saying, well, you gotta have or you can't waste the primes of these players. Like I understand it. Like I understand like they're in their primes, but like there's so much more that makes a team in baseball. I don't know. How do you feel about that?
No, I absolutely agree. I think I kind of attack it from a different perspective where Bryce Harper being on the Phillies should not have happened. It's a complete one in a million chance that this dude, yeah, I mean, we're talking generational talent. That is a generational talent. All on Sports Illustrated at what, 15 years old, hitting 400 foot home runs. Like, this was the pinnacle of generational talent, wins an MVP, was killed us for years in DC. For whatever reason, John Middleton tricked him into signing with the Phillies, right? Like, we agree that that probably shouldn't have happened. He's here. He's on a favorable contract. he's been very, very good since signing. Has he won an MVP yet? No. I mean, he was absolutely incredible last year prior to his back injury. I agree with the point. Having Harper, having Wheeler, having Real Muto, Nola, Didi, that's not enough to win you a championship. It's not even enough to get you into the playoffs, especially the way the NL East is built. But I think that should be the motivation to start going all in, which I think, for the record, John Middleton, right up against the luxury tax, I have to give him a little bit of credit for hiring Dave Dombrowski, hiring Sam Fold, and committing to spending, you know, $200 million this year. But I think when you have that amount of talent, I do agree that you need to try your best not to, you know, quote unquote, waste them. But that comes with better drafting, better scouting, better player development, you know, play in the margins with some of your trades. It's not always just about throwing as much money as you can at free agency.
Yeah. And like, I mean, it makes sense to me. Like, I know you write about all Philly sports, like Embiid and Simmons, it's different. Like when you say you don't want to waste the Embiid's MVP season, his prime, like I get that. It's the NBA. Like the NBA, you can have LeBron and D Wade and you can be set up to win a freaking title. I mean, LeBron has taken the Cavs to titles by himself. So like that's different. I just kind of wanted to put that out there just so the people that are watching this and other Phillies fans can know that, like, look, this isn't other sports. You've got to have everything. Look at the Nationals 2 years ago. Maybe that's a bad example. I don't know. But I mean, they had pitching, they had all this pitching, not just Scherzer and Strasburg. It was a lot. It took Howie Kendrick having clutch hits in the playoffs. I mean, who knew that Howie Kendrick was going to do that? You know what I mean? Like, yeah. So, but just wanted to put that out there.